In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the coming of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
My beloved friends in Jesus, good evening.
Good evening, Father.
And praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And happy welcome to the celebration of God's love and mercy. On this fourth Sunday of Easter, we celebrate the Good Shepherd Sunday. This is the day to proclaim, as Peter in today's first reading, filled with the Holy Spirit, he proclaimed, "Our risen Lord is our cornerstone, the rock of salvation and refuge. Our risen Lord is our good shepherd, our strength and shelter." And this is the day to pray for our shepherds, our Pope Francis, our bishops, our clergy, deacons, and all those who are doing great shepherding at home, workplace, and in the society. And with a heavy heart, let you know the passing of Isaiah Bridges, the beloved cousin of Trish, our secretary. Let's pray for the repose of the soul of Isaiah Bridges. And on this Monday, April 26th, our beloved Nancy King celebrates her birthday. Nancy is not here, but King is here. Tomorrow she will be here. Anyway, all the blessings of the day. Any more birthdays or wedding anniversary on this week? Let's pray for a moment. Today is also the World Day of Prayer for Vocations. Vocations to priesthood, consecrated life, and hyperlight. We pray for our nation, our Catholic Church, our Pope, our bishops, our clergy, and all those who are doing great shepherding in the church. We pray for our parish family, our families, and all our loved ones, especially those who are sick and suffering from various diseases and disasters. This Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Teresa Curry. Let's offer all our prayers, personal intentions, our sorrows, sufferings, sickness, pains, tears, all our fears and frustrations to the hands of the Lord. And guard our mind, all our sins against love of God and love of neighbor. And so prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my thought, through my heart, through my most grievous heart. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
A reading from the Holy Gospel. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely by what means he was saved, then all of you and all of the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed." He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hired man, who is not a shepherd, and whose sheep are not his own, sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away, and the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have power to lay it down and power to take it up again. This commandment I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My beloved friends in Jesus, once again, good evening. And praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And how are you?
I'm good.
As I said in the beginning, today we celebrate the Good Shepherd Sunday. This is the day to proclaim, as Peter proclaimed in today's first reading, the risen Lord is our cornerstone. And filled with the Holy Spirit, he said, in his name, this man stands before you healed. He said again, there is not any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved. So, this is the day to proclaim our risen Lord is our good shepherd, our strength and shelter, our rock of refuge and salvation. This is the day our good shepherd tells us to be the good shepherd at your home, at your workplace, and in the society. And this is the day to pray for our shepherds. Our Pope Francis, our bishops, our clergy, our deacons, and all those who are doing great, great service of shepherding in the society. And today is also the World Day of Prayer for Vocation, so that we may have holy and spirit-filled shepherds to live for God and for the people of God. It has been said that a pastor ought to have 4 weeks vacation each year, because if he is a good shepherd, he deserves it. If he is not a good shepherd, his congregation deserves it. So please pray for us, all the shepherds. At Jesus' time, it was very common that the good shepherds bring the sheep into the sheepfold every night, and the shepherds lay at the gate all night to protect and save his sheep from wild beasts. So the sheep couldn't get out of the sheepfold, or any wild beast couldn't get in without stepping over or hurting or killing the shepherds first. Seeing this great sacrifice of the shepherds, Jesus today proclaims, "I am the good shepherd. I am the good shepherd." Then Jesus reveals the 5 qualities of a good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down and sacrifices his life for his sheep. Second, he knows and calls by name his sheep. Third, he guides and leads his sheep. He cares and protects his sheep, and he makes one flock his sheep. And my dear friends, we are born and baptized to follow Jesus, our good shepherd. And we are born and baptized to be the good shepherds at your home, at your workplace, and in the society. As a good shepherd, we all need to have love and compassion, dedication, commitment, and the willingness for selfless service and sacrifice. We become good shepherds by loving, caring, and forgiving, and being patient to those entrusted us, praying for them, finding time to listen to them, being with them, by encouraging and supporting them, spending our time and talents for their welfare, and protecting them from our dangers. And today, Jesus also reminds us to be the good sheep in the fold of Jesus by listening, obeying, respecting, and following the ways and voice of the good shepherd. With the apostolic letter, Patris Cordi, with a father's heart, Pope Francis recalls the 150th anniversary of the dedication of Saint Joseph as the patron of the universal church. To mark the occasion, the Holy Father has proclaimed the year of Saint Joseph from 18th December 2022 8th December 2021, the year of Saint Joseph. Pope Francis in this letter describes Saint Joseph as a beloved father, a tender and loving father, an obedient father, an accepting father. A father is courageous and a hardworking father. He is the faithful, humble, and obedient and courageous shepherd of the Holy Family, the patron and protector of Catholic Church. Pope Francis here inspires us to be the good shepherds by making Saint Joseph our good model and mediator. And Pope Francis once said, a good shepherd is passionate and selfless. The one who is with the fire of love in his heart, he should have the ability to discern where the dangers are and the graces are, and he should have the ability to denounce and say no to evil, like the good parents to their baby. When the baby goes to the electric socket to put his finger in, that loving father will say, no, no, my kid, it is dangerous. It is dangerous. So we are the good shepherds. So let's ask God's grace to have the fire of love in our heart and to have the ability to discern and denounce. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
God bless.
I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us sinners.
Let's pray. Our risen Lord is our good shepherd, strength, and shelter. There is no other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved. Let's gather all our prayers and personal intentions to the hands of the Lord.
In today's gospel reading, Jesus tells us that he is the good shepherd who was prepared to lay down his life for us. We pray that we may be forever in his care and be worthy of the love he has bestowed on us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this Good Shepherd Sunday, we pray that the Holy Spirit enlighten the leaders of our church and all those in our church, men and women, ordained and lay, and all parents and all those who have been called to the role of shepherd, that they may follow closely the example of Christ and bear witness to his goodness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this World Day of Prayer for Vocations, we pray for the vocations to the priesthood, the diaconate, and the consecrated life, so that we may have holy and spirit-filled shepherds to live for God and for the people of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our parish family and for all our family and their loved ones, and especially for the Clark family, the Shelton family, the Martins, and the Cummings families. As we continue to rejoice in the risen Lord, we pray that our family homes will be places where we experience healing, peace, and forgiveness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those in our community who are sick, especially those whose names are listed in our church bulletin, especially for Kim, Evelyn, and Kaylee, that the Lord may ease their pain and bring them to a speedy recovery. We pray particularly for those around the world who are affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have recently lost loved ones and ask the Lord to comfort them. And we pray for the dead, especially for Isaiah Bridges, Teresa Curry, George Baptiste, James Ritter, Linda Geyer, and Anna Parker, for whom masses are offered this week. May they continue to inspire us, to intercede for us, and be there at the end to welcome us in our turn into eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bow our heads now and remember in silence our own personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Asking the intercession of Mother Mary, Saint Joseph, all the angels and saints, let's pray together. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary.
O most merciful risen Lord, bless our nation, our Catholic Church, our shepherds, our parish family, our parents, our beloved children, our spouses, and all our loved ones, especially those who are sick and suffering. Bestow on us your grace to be the good shepherds at our home and our society. Good shepherds of love and compassion, dedication, commitment, with the willingness of selfless service and sacrifice. Bestow on us your grace to have the fire of love in our heart and to have the ability to discern and denounce what is good and evil. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Jesus. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, and from hence it will become for us bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, and from hence it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice words may be acceptable to the Almighty Father. Grant we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these pastoral mysteries so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with
you.
Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty of salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, our Son, Lord, never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with festive joy, every lunch, every people excels in your praise, and even the heavenly powers sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, and from hence it will become our spiritual drink.
Parley Dukar, Dissuci Free, by sending down your spirit upon them like the before, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and earned his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice, my blood, and the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. You are worthy to be present and minister to you, humbly to that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Stephen, our Bishop, our bishops, all the clergy, and all the people. Remember your servant Teresa Curry and Isaiah Bridges, whom you have called from this world of diversity. Remember also our brothers and sisters fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who are the mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, or we pray. Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be praised life, and may praise and glorify the Son Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, and the mighty Father, who needed the Holy Spirit, our glory in honor is yours forever and ever. receives command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to sing. Before the Lamb of God, before the King who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those for the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but I must say the word, and my soul shall be.
That's what we need to actually pay for, but we have to have the order right now, so we need to start getting on the stick with that and help support the mics and all the good work that we do. And if you need some more information, CD or Bruce Large, after the past, but actually, Bruce is going to be able to be honest with us. We're going to have an update on our renovations to the church here over at Mason Hall right off the mat. So everyone needs to go over there and hopefully don't get soaked wet. It's like it's storming out. So we'll have an update no matter what. Bruce has got some real good video presentation on whatever slides or things. Bruce, you got one up there?
Yes.
Okay. So we need to go there right up here to Mass and see all the wonderful things that are going to take place when they start the construction and set the little thing out there on the front and all the things. Oh, it's going to be wonderful. So, the other thing is 2021 graduating class. If you have a family member who will be graduating from high school or college this year, please contact Trisha or Brady at the office with the name of the person and the school which they're graduating from so that we can give them the degree tax for life. Is that it?
Thank you, Andy. Thank you.
One more?
Yes, sir. Big thanks to every king and all are welcome to Mercy Hall to watch our updates on our renovation project. And thank you, my altar angels, Bill and Mary. And thank you, my wonderful choir, Barbara, John, Ellie, and Steve. Thank you so much. Thank you, Ron Koss, being the lecturer of the day. Thank you so much. Thank you, my attorneys, Bruce and Sunars, and Jock Sugar. Thank you so much. And take care outside from storm, lightning, and thunder. Yes. You are free to stay here. Thank you. God bless. Have a great week to you all. Thank you. Let's pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to set it in the care of pastors, the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
And thank you, Brian and Haley. Thank you, all of you. God bless you. Have a great day.
Maybe we should stay here.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Our reception today is number 5.